Hello friends, now we are going to see all about the meiosis. Okay, now what are the topics we are going to cover in this video is cell division, types of cell division, what is meiosis cell division, history of meiosis, where it occurs, facts about the meiosis, phases of meiosis, prophase 1, and again the meiosis 1 we divided into prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. And again the prophase is in turn divided into leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene and diakinesis. Crossing over, importance of crossing over, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1, phases of meiosis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, telophase 2. Importance of meiosis, difference between mitosis and meiosis. Coming to the next, cell division. Cell division is the process by which a parent cell divides into two or more daughter cells. All cells are derived from pre-existing cells. This is the statement given by Rudolf Virchow. He is the one who completed the cell theory. It is necessary to replace the worn-off cells in multicellular organisms. It is required for growth in multicellular organisms. It is necessary for reproduction in unicellular and multicellular organisms. For all these things, we need cell divisions. Either it may be mitosis or meiosis. Coming to the next, cells can divide, and in unicellular organisms, this makes more organisms. In multicellular organisms, cell division is used for growth, development, and repair of organism. Cell division is controlled by DNA. Types of cell divisions. Mainly cell divisions is of three types. Amitosis, mitosis and meiosis. Mitos means thread-like formation. So we can see a thread-like formation in this division. Amitosis means absence of thread-like formation during the cell division. Because of that they named it as amitosis. Meiosis means reductional division. Initially the parental cell is diploid. Finally the daughter cells will be haploid. Because of that it is named it as meiosis. What is meiosis cell division? Meiosis is a special type of cell division necessary for sexual reproduction in eukaryotes. Meiosis begins with one diploid cell containing two copies of each chromosome. One is from organism's mother, one is from its father. Produces the four haploid cells containing one copy of each chromosome. Here we have the parent cell. So at the first interphase, the DNA will undergo replication. In the interphase again is divided into G1, S and G2. In the first meiotic division, the cell will undergo meiosis and two daughter cells is been formed. In the second meiosis division, four daughter cells is formed with haploid set of chromosomes which is different from parent cell. So these are the events is going to happen in meiosis. History of meiosis. Meiosis was discovered and described for the first time in sea urchin eggs in 1876 by German biologist Oskar Hertwig. It was described again in 1883 at the level of chromosomes by the Belgian zoologist Eduardo van Benden in Ascaris worm eggs. The term meiosis was coined by J.B. Farmer and J.B. Moore in the year 1905. Where it occurs. Meiosis occurs in eukaryotic life cycle involving sexual reproduction. It always occurs in reproductive cells. We call it as meiosite. In lower plants, meiosis occurs after fertilization in zygote. Yeah, for the formation of spores, meiosis is needed not only for the formation of gametes. But in the higher plants, before fertilization in the time of gametic formation, the meiosis will occur. In the lower plants, after the zygote formation for the production of spores, the meiosis will occur. That is the difference between the lower plants and higher plants. Facts about meiosis. Meiosis is the type of cell division by which germ cells are produced. Two meiotic divisions are there, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, called reduction division. Original cell is diploid in nature. Four daughter cells produce it at the monoploid. Daughter cells contain half the number of chromosomes as the original cell, produces the gametes, egg and sperms. So, occurs in the testis in the male through spermatogenesis, occurs in the ovaries in female through oogenesis. During meiosis, DNA replicates once, but nucleus divides twice. Here it is a very, very important point. During meiosis, DNA will replicate once, but nucleus will divide twice. Phases of meiosis 1. Meiosis 1, the reduction division. So first meiosis, we call it as reduction division because it will have half the number of the chromosomes than the parent cell. The second meiosis is very similar to mitosis or equational division. So first meiosis, we call it as reduction division. Second meiosis, we call it as equational division. So the diploid mother cell produces two haploid cells. It has interphase. After interphase, it moves to prophase 1. And again, the prophase is divided into leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene, and diagenesis. And metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1. These are the phases of meiosis 1. So, this is the interphase, which is a preparatory phase. It is again divided into gap 1, synthesis, and gap 2 phases. This is the early prophase. Early prophase is again divided into leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene, and diagenesis. And we have the late prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Prophase 1. During the prophase 1, DNA is exchanged between homologous chromosomes, which is a process called as homologous recombination. This often results in chromosomal crossing over. The paired and replicated chromosomes are, we call it as bivalent or tetrad. The process of pairing the homologous chromosomes is called it as synopsis. Here the pairing of homologous chromosomes means, for example, the chromosomes which exhibiting the same character. For example, in an organism, in a diploid state, one set is from father and one set is from mother. If the father chromosome is representing the hair color, the same hair color chromosome from the mother, two chromosomes, that same type of chromosomes, one is from father, one is from mother. We call it as homologous chromosomes. So that pairing of that homologous chromosomes will be happen. So that we call it as synapsis. At this stage, the non-sister chromatids may cross over at a point called chiasma. Chi means in the Greek X. So it will be in a form of X shaped on the crossing over. This we will discuss in the next slides in a very detailed manner. First, in the prophase is again divided into leptotene. The first stage of prophase 1 is the leptotene stage. Leptotene is also known as leptonema from Greek words meaning thin threads. During this stage, individual chromosomes begin to condense into long strands within the nucleus. However, the two sister chromatids are still tightly bounded and they are indistinguishable from one another. So, the formation of thin thread-like structures will be seen in the leptotene stage. Because of that, it is named it as leptotene. Next, zygotene. So, zygote is formed from mother, male and female. So, zygote means pair. So, the zygotene stage is also known as zygonema from the Greek word meaning paired threads. So, the zygotene occurs as the chromosomes approximately line up with each other into homologous chromosomes. So, this combination of homologous chromosomes we call it as bivalent. So, bivalent is the name given by number of chromosomes. Here we have two number of chromosomes. So, always the number of chromosomes has been numbered based on centromeres. Here we have two centromeres. The center constriction we call it as centromere. So, in this picture you can able to see the two constrictions. So, we have two chromosomes. And we also call this bivalent as tetrad. Tetrad is the nomenclature based on number of chromatids. Here we call 1, 2, 3, 4 chromatids. 2 chromosomes and 4 chromatids. So, bivalent is named of the number of chromosomes. Tetrad is named of the number of chromatids. So, this is about zygotene. This pairing of the homologous chromosomes. One is from father and one is from mother. This we call it as synaptonemal complex. Means they are coming close and lining up from top to bottom. Pachytene stage. In pachytene, the homologous chromosomes become much more closely associated. This process is known as synapsis. The synapsed homologous pair of chromosomes is called tetrad because it consists of 4 chromatids. It cannot be observed until the next stage, but the synapsed chromosomes may undergo crossing over in the pachytene stage. So the chromosomes continue to condense. In this picture, we can able to see one chromosome is, so the relationship between, once again, the relationship between this chromatid and this chromatid is sister chromatids. And the relationship between this blue chromatid and red chromatid is non-sister chromatids. Okay. So, the crossing over will take place between non-sister chromatids. Okay. So, crossing over means overlapping of one chromatid over other. We call it as crossing over. Next, diplotene stage. During diplotene stage, it is also known as diplonema, from the Greek word two threads. So, the homologous chromosomes separate from one another a little. So, after crossing over has been done, means the chromatid has to get exchanged. The chromosomes themselves will uncoil a bit, allowing some transcription of DNA in this phase. So, we can see the chiasma formation in the diplotene. Chi means this X-like formation. So, exchange of chromatids will take place with this chiasma. So, after crossing over only, the chiasma will take place. First, it will be forming of thin threads. Next, it will be synaptonemal complex. After synaptonemal complex, we will have the crossing over. After crossing over, chiasmata formation. Diakinesis. Chromosome condense further during the diakinesis stage, from Greek word meaning moving through. So, after exchanging of the chromatids, it has to split, right? So, this is the first point in the meiosis where the four parts of the tetrads are actually visible. Yes, during this phase only, actually the four parts of the tetrad is visible. In this stage, the homologous chromosomes will separate further and the chiasmata will terminalize, making the chiasma clearly visible. We can see the exchange of the colors. So, this chromatid has gone to this, this chromatid has to go on to this. So, the exchange of chromatid material has been seen in this part. So, this whole movement, which we call it as diakinesis. So, different stages of the mitotic prophase 1, leptonema, zygonema. So, in the leptonema, the chromosomes will form with thin thread-like structures. In zygonema, bivalence or tetrad. In pachytene, crossing over. In diplotene, diplonema, chiasma. In diakinesis, the breaking of the chiasma and movement of the chromosomes away. Crossing over. During prophase 1 of meiosis, a part of chromatid of one chromosome goes over to a chromatid of other chromosome or vice versa. This interchange of parts of chromatids of a pair of homologous chromosomes, which we know it as crossing over. Here, so it is been, this is before crossing over. This is crossing over. This is after crossing over. There is exchange of chromatid material. So, the crossing over is a process by which the two chromosomes of an homologous pair exchange equal segments with each other. So, crossing over occurs in a first division of meiosis. So, synapsis. So, synapsis, pairing of the homologous chromosomes. Homologous chromosome in a tetrad cross over each other. A pieces of the chromosomes of the genes are exchanged in this picture, produces the genetic recombination of offspring. So, crossing over is the basis for variation. Importance of crossing over. Crossing over takes place between the non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. Crossing over is one of the most important events in meiosis because it allows the variation in the produced offsprings. Produces new individual having new combination of traits, helped in establishing the concept of linear arrangement of genes, helps in the mapping of chromosomes, selection of useful recombination. This is the importance of crossing over. So, new type of variations has been developed with crossing over. Metaphase 1. Again, after completion of the prophase, metaphase 1 is the second phase of meiosis. Always remind, when it comes to metaphase, remind the word middle. So, the tetrad from the prophase 1 line up in the middle of the dividing cell randomly. So, here the tetrads. So, the homologous chromosome will pair up and it will remain in the middle. So, the spindle fiber attaches to the tetrad from both the ends of the cells. Here, the lining up of the homologous chromosomes in the center metaphyseal plate will take place in metaphase 1. Okay? The spindle fibers will attach to each side of the chromosome. Next, anaphase 1. Anaphase 1 begins when the two chromosomes of each bivalent start separate and start moving towards the opposite pole, A for away. So in anaphase 1, the sister chromatids remain attached at their centromeres and move together towards the poles. So this is the anaphase. In anaphase, normally in the mitotic anaphase, the centromere will split. But in the meiotic anaphase 1, the centromeres will not split. The division of the homologous chromosomes only will take place. So this homologous chromosome will go to this side and this chromosome will go to this side. Telophase 1. The homologous chromosome pair each the poles of the cell. So the homologous chromosome pair complete their migration to the two poles. So telophase, T for 2, remain 2. A nuclear envelope reform around the each chromosome set. The spindle will disappear and the cytokinesis will follow. Okay. So this is the cleavage furrow method. This is for animal cell. If it is plate formation, this is for plant cell. This is for plant cell and this is for animal cell. Coming to the next, figures of meiosis. So this is the interphase. G1, S and G2. And again meiosis 1, separation of homologous chromosomes. We have prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. In the prophase, the whole process of crossing over, chiasmata, everything will take place. In the metaphase 1, the alignment of the homologous chromosomes, crossing over, finished crossing over homologous chromosomes will line up like this. And later in anaphase, splitting of the chromosomes will take place. Splitting of homologous chromosomes will take place. And this is again prophase 1. We have the telophase 1. So in the metaphase 1, one pair of homologous chromosomes. One set of the chromosomes will go to this side in the anaphase and one set of the chromosomes will go to this side. Means 23 chromosomes will go to this side and 23 chromosomes will go to this side. Now there is reduction in the number of the chromosomes in the each cells. Phases of meiosis 2. In the meiosis 2, mitotic divisions of the two haploid cells will produce four daughter cells. Okay, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2. This division we call it as equational division, which is very similar to mitosis. Prophase 2. So meiosis 2 begins without any further replication of chromosomes. In prophase 2, the nuclear envelope will break down and spindle apparatus will form. So while the chromosome duplication took place prior to the meiosis 1, so no new chromosomal replication occur before meiosis 2. The centrioles will duplicate. This occur by separation of two member of the pairs, then formation of daughter centriole perpendicular to each other to the original centriole. So the two pair of centrioles separate into two centrosomes. So the nuclear envelope will break down and the spindle apparatus will form. Here again, nothing but in the prophase 2, the condensation of the chromatin material to the chromosomes will happen and dissolution of the nuclear membrane and nucleolus will occur. Metaphase 2. The chromosomes become arranged on the metaphase plate. Centromeres are arranged in the line in the equatorial plate of invisible spindle fibers. Previously occurring the nuclear membrane is not present. So here, same the metaphase 2. So the arrangement of the chromosomes in the center. Here the chromosomes we call it as dyad, with having only two chromatids. So there we call it, in the meiosis 1 we call it as tetrad, here we call it as dyad. Anaphase 2, the centromeres will separate and the sister chromatids, now individual chromosomes, move towards the opposite pole. So the separated chromatids are now called it as chromosomes on their own right. So here the splitting of the centromeres will take place in the anaphase 2 and the separation of sister chromatids will happen. After separation of sister chromatids, this will develop into a single chromosome. Next, telophase 2. Nuclear envelope forms around each set of the chromosomes. Nucleolus will appear in the each nucleus. Chromosomes will lengthen and become indistinct. Means nothing but decondensation of the chromosomes will happen to form like a chromatin material. Next, figures in the meiosis 2. So prophase 2, metaphase 2. So in the prophase 2, the nucleolus and nuclear membrane will be dissolution, and later the chromosomes will appear. And here in the metaphase 2, the alignment of the chromosomes in the center. In the anaphase, the splitting of the centromere and separation of the sister chromatids, forming so individual chromosomes. After the telophase, forming the two separate nuclei will be seen in telophase 2. And finally, haploid number of the chromosomes will be seen in each daughter cells, with the four cells finally. So these are again different stages in the meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Importance of meiosis: produces the haploid gamete so that the diploid number of species remain constant generation after generation. Source of genetic variation, because crossing over brings together new combination of chromosomes. So differences between meiosis and mitosis is: mitosis occurs in body cells, meiosis occurs in reproductive cells. Mitosis, number of the chromosomes will remain same in the daughter cells. Here the number of chromosomes is halved in the daughter cell. The daughter cells are identical to parent cell in each other. In the meiosis, four daughter cells. So the daughter cells are genetically different to the parent cell and each other. So two daughter cells are formed here. Here four daughter cells are formed. Homologous chromosomes do not come together. Here the homologous chromosomes will come together. There is no exchange of genetic material between the chromosomes. There is exchange of genetic material between the chromosomes will happen.